On their latest album, Mints of Fearum switched from their tried and true Viking metal over to its more oddball cousin, pirate metal. But to be fair, the Vikings did a lot of pirate things themselves. They just look a little more badass while they did it. Greetings, hardened heavy music fans. I'm Dante with the Heavy Haystack, and today I'm taking a look at the new album from Finnish metal band Insafirum, titled Thalassic. Insafirum play what they call folk-inspired metal. They take the traditional instrumentation, fun vibe, and anthemic choruses of folk metal and beef that up with the intensity, electric guitar work, and screamy vocals of melodic death metal. This style has made the band one of the biggest under the folk metal banner, where they have the distinctly melodic European elements with enough grit and aggression to appeal to North American metal fans. I'm still a relatively new fan to the folk metal genre, but Insafirum was one of the first bands I latched onto after hearing their 2017 album Two Paths. Its fast-paced, thrashy, and aggressive energy made the sea shanty hooks and melodic elements a lot more palatable to other folk metal bands that I heard up to that point. And speaking of sea shanties, this new album marks a shift in lyrical focus for the band. Insafirum is known as part of the Viking metal subgenre, with most of their lyrics dealing with Viking battles and its related lore. On this album, however, the lyrics shift to more pirate-themed and sea battle-focused lyrics, with the album's title Thalassic meaning of or related to the seas. The album dives headfirst into this theme, where after the orchestral opening titled Seafarer's Dream, it goes into the energetic lead single titled Rum, Women, Victory, which is piratey as fuck. It's a briskly paced thrasher that'll make you want to circle pit while downing Captain Morgan until you lose your sea legs. Halfway through this song, the band displays one of the strongest new weapons in their arsenal, keyboardist and melodic vocalist Pekka Montin. His strong voice adds a quality power metal element to this album, which make the hooks on the record stick, and it balances pretty well with the raspy shouts from guitarist Petri Lindruus. The fifth track of this album, Run From the Crushing Tide, follows a similar formula, with Montin's melodic vocals being even more prominent for the hook of that song. The band doesn't go blistering for the entire album, however. There's a trio of catchy mid-tempo songs that well balances the metal, folk, and orchestral elements that the band employs. The first of these is on track 3 titled Andromeda, named after the goddess of the Greek pantheon. It's a jaunty yet driving track that has trade-offs of the screamed and sung vocals and upbeat melodic guitar riffs, making it an earworm upon first listen. The defensive Sampo has a group sing-along at its center, and is sung fully melodically with a fun galloping rhythm throughout. This makes it one of the more purely folk metal songs of the record. Four Sirens also has a galloping rhythm, and probably has the catchiest hook of the record next to Rum, Women, Victory. It also makes use of the sung, screamed, vocal trade-off method again. That's one knock on the record that I can say. While there's fast and mid-tempo songs and even a slow ballad, there's not a world of difference between songs of the same type. However, each song on the record stands pretty well on its own, and with the album only being 9 tracks long, with one of those being an orchestral instrumental intro, there's not much of a drag or feeling of repetitiveness that makes any part of the album feel overly boring or slow. This album does get pretty diverse in its last third, starting with the power ballad One with the Sea, which is aided by rousing orchestration and Pekka Montin's melodic vocals taking center stage once more. Midsummer Magic is the most folksy track of the record, with it alternating between the loud metal parts, jaunty sing-alongs, and the fully acoustic folk parts, which include some lyrics that sound like they're sung in the band's native Finnish. Closing out the album is the 9-minute epic Cold Northland, which makes such strong use of orchestra that it could be considered a symphonic metal track, and makes for a fitting ending to the album as a whole. All in all, Thalassic is a fun and quality album front to back. The song is solid with many catchy moments, and despite not a world of diversity between the track types, the execution of the songs stick the landing. Being only 9 tracks long, the album doesn't overstay its welcome long enough to be able to get boring. It's another quality entry into the Insafirum discography, and it gets a rating of 3.5 out of 5 from me. What did you think of the new album from Insafirum? Does folk metal even tickle your fancy? Is the pirate's life for you? Leave a comment, like, and subscribe to the Heavy Haystack to see more videos just like this one. Peace, love, and music, and I'll see y'all next time.